Hello guys, this is Harish Nagar and today I am going to talk about Nayantara Sehgal. Nayantara Sehgal was born in 1927 and she is currently alive. She is a member of the Nehru family because she is the second of the three daughters born to Jawaharlal Nehru sister Vidya Lakshmi Pandit. So remember, she has a connection with the Nehru family and therefore she has a very important political upbringing as well. Now we are going to look at five works of Nayantara Sehgal in this lecture. But since they have not asked many questions from this writer, we will not be going into the detail of her work. Now guys, the first work is Prison and Chocolate Cake. Prison and Chocolate Cake was published in the year 1954 and it is an autobiography and memoir which is talking about Nayantara's youth and about Nehru family in general. Now the next work is Storm in Chandigarh. This was published in the year 1969 and it is a story of interpersonal relationship of few couples who lived in Chandigarh when the division of Punjab was taking place. So guys, the story talk about Chandigarh and how the people of Chandigarh face this problem of division. The next work is The Day in Shadow. This was published in the year 1971 and it is about a divorcee struggling in male-dominant society. So guys, it talks about divorce and its implications in Indian society. And guys, this is the story of Samrit and she struggled to cope up with the emotional shock of a divorce and plus a brutal divorce settlement inflicted on her. Finally, we come on to the most important work of Nayantara Sehgal, which is Rich Like Us. This was published in the year 1985 and it is a Sahitya Academy winner book. So obviously you can see that it is important. It is also historic and a political fiction. The main theme and the main plot of this work talk about two upper class female. One is Rose and the other one is Sonali. So who is Rose? Rose is a British immigrant and she is wife of a party powerful businessman Ram. And on the other hand, Sonali was a highly educated civil servant from an upper class society. Now what happened is that Rose struggled to find a sense of home in this foreign society because she is from a foreign nation and she has married Ram. So she find problem to fit in the Indian culture, which is filled with ancient customs including sati, and there are so many exotic social standards for females, and she is entangled in this marriage because she is second wife of Ram. So there is also a lot of problem related to acceptance by the kids from Ram. Ram's kids treated her like a stepmother, so they don't give a proper respect. Now Rose suffered to understand the Indian culture and the ramification on the female spirit. And guys, when Ram's health deteriorates, she realizes that her rights as a wife are in question. And there are so many people who are after the assets of Ram. So Ram has a son whose name is Dev from the first wife of Ram. The first wife of Ram was Mona. So Dev schemes to take all the assets of Ram so that he can dispose of Rose. And guys, in fear that all her wealth, all her rights as a wife would be taken, she turns to Sonali. And Sonali is a young civil servant, aristocratic woman. She helped Rose to come out in this problem. And the story revolves around how both these females help each other in order to overcome the problems faced in their life. Now guys, there was a question in January 2017 and they asked us to match the novelist with the work, and Nayantara Sehgal correctly matched with Rich Like Us. Finally, we come on to the last work of Nayantara Sehgal, which is Mistaken Identity. This was published in the year 1988 and it talks about Bhushan Singh, who is purposeless but amiable son of a Raja, and he was traveling on a train when he was arrested mistakenly. So he is mistakenly charged and he is arrested and thrown into the jail. Now when he is in the jail, he entertains all of them with the tales of his world. He talk about his mother and about his Farsi girlfriend and talk about that how he feels to have a modern girlfriend, because the Farsi girlfriend he talk about, she wears dresses. This is a very uncommon thing for the Indian at that time. Wearing dresses and being so modern was not acceptable by the Indian society. But since we can see that he is quite happy with that change, he is talking about tales of his world, about his mother and about his relationship with other people. So guys, in this lecture, we have talked about five works of Nayantara Sehgal, namely Prison and Chocolate Cake, published in 1954, Storm in Chandigarh, published in 1969, Days in Shadow, published in 1971, Rich Like Us, published in 1985, and Mistaken Identity, published in 1988. So that's it for today's lecture, guys. Thank you.